Hi everyone, it's Bethany from Madeline Jean Antiques and Restoration. In this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about distressing painted furniture. Now, in the furniture painted world, you've probably come across many painted pieces that are either lightly distressed or heavily distressed. Now, personally, I'm not a big fan of the big distressed look where it looks like someone just takes some of the pieces I come across, they're comical to me, but it looks like somebody takes a sander to the top of it, to the side, and it just looks like the thing has been thrown off a cliff and they're trying to make it out to be that it's been naturally distressed. I don't like a lot of distressing when it comes to my painted pieces. I just like a little bit of distressing. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys on this custom piece that I've been working on. This is a gorgeous antique dresser. It has a mirror and a frame that it sits in above. I've done a two-tone look on this dresser. The drawers are not in at the moment, and there's a reason why. It's because we're going to be distressing the edges here and along where the drawers go in. So I need the drawers out, obviously. I'll also be distressing along the frame. The top of the frame is painted, so I'm just going to lightly distress along the edges on this piece. So I'm going to show you guys how I distress a piece of furniture. It's not that hard. So the supplies that you will need, you're going to need a felt block. If you've watched any of my videos, you've heard me talk about my felt blocks. Get one, get one, get one. They're cheap and they're so handy. They're just a great piece of, a supply to have in your arsenal of supplies. I use them all the time. Okay, so get yourself a felt block. What we're also going to need is 400 grit sandpaper and 150 grit sandpaper. Okay, these come in large sheets and then I just cut them in fourths. Okay, do not invest in the sanding blocks. They look like this. Sanding blocks, don't get one, because they run about $4 or $5 a piece, and what happens is they get all full of paint and you end up pitching them in like one or two uses, so it's not worth your money. Get yourself a felt block, get yourself the cheap sandpaper that comes in full sheets, cut them in fourths, and do it this way. I'm trying to help you here. Just listen, okay? I'm a mom. Open those listening ears, people. Felt block, cheap sandpaper, all right? I'm gonna reposition my camera and we're gonna start distressing this dresser. All right, you guys, I am down here by my freshly painted dresser. I've let this dresser dry overnight. So before I distress a piece of furniture, I let it dry overnight. So that's anywhere between 12 and 24 hours before I start distressing. Now, I make my own chalk paint with latex paint. I always get my latex paint in a matte finish, and then I make my own chalk paint. How do I do that? Check out the link below in this video. I'm going to show you my homemade chalk recipe. Go watch that video. Very simple to make. So I made my own chalk paint for this piece of furniture. The paint has dried for, I'm coming up on 24 hours, and now it's time to distress it. So I have my felt block. What I start with is I always start with a higher grain with my sandpaper, because I just don't know how easily the paint is gonna come off. So you would rather start with a finer sanding paper and just see how well it comes off. If it's not coming off very easily with your 400 grit sandpaper, knock it down to a rougher sandpaper, 150 grit, and see if that works. Again, with distressing, it's all about making it look natural. You want to make it look like, oh, this piece got knocked around a little bit, or someone's, you know, ran into it in the middle of the night, something like I would do because I'm such a klutz, along the edging. So you want to distress not in the middle, not on the top. I mean, obviously mine is stained, but if this was painted, I would not be distressing anything on the top. I would be distressing along the edges. So if you are a first-time distressor, just stick with the edges. Stick along the edges where the drawers go in, because yes, naturally the chip would be, the paint would be worn down in those areas where the drawers go in. So that's where we're gonna focus, right here on this strip here. I'm gonna start with 400 grit sandpaper. I'm gonna wrap it around my felt block like that. And then I'm just gonna lightly go back and forth until I see some of that natural wood peeking through. Now, I've got like 3 coats of paint on. I can already see, you're not gonna be able to see, but I can already see the natural wood peeking through. So 400 grit is gonna be just fine for this project. If I found that the paint wasn't coming off, then I would probably go down to my 150 grit. So we're gonna continue to just lightly. Again, my customer just wants a little bit of distressing. She wants to keep this piece looking very classy, very rustic farmhouse look. So she doesn't want it looking like really chippy. Chippy is a word where you use that in painted furniture where the paint is really just kind of coming off everywhere. So we want just a lightly distressed look. I'm gonna go along the edges here where the drawer would fit in. You can see here, I'm just lightly feather sanding across my piece. And then I'll show you some close-ups of it's coming right off and it's looking beautiful. So when you distress, you don't want the whole line of the wood to be peeking through. You just want it coming in every now and again. So I'm gonna show you with my finger where the wood is peeking through. Here, 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 here. As you can see, there's gaps. So there's a little bit of wood peeking through and then some paint. You want it to just look like a really pretty natural distressed look. And it's so simple. So you just do that along the edges, all along your piece. You get it to the look that you prefer. Again, some people like a more distressed look. I prefer just a light, natural look when it comes to distressing. It's up to you, your preference. Once you're done distressing, you can put your top coat on. So a lot of people use clear wax over chalk paint, or they'll use a polycrylic in a matte finish or a satin finish. And when you apply any of those top coats, you're gonna notice the areas where the wood is peeking through, it's gonna get a little darker, which is great because then your distressed areas are gonna even pop even more and it just looks even more beautiful. So I'm gonna show you guys some close-ups of me distressing, get my mug out of here so you guys can really see what I'm doing. Okay, you guys, there's the close-up of the bottom of where that drawer goes in. You can see the distressed. See what I'm talking about? It doesn't go all the way across. It intermittently lets that natural wood peek through. Just wanted to give you guys a close-up of that. So then I'm gonna try and film and distress at the same time. So here we are on that second area. Here's my felt block. And I am just lightly sanding. And it goes pretty fast. There you go. There's some more distressed areas. And again, I'm gonna be doing that along all the edges. Very simple.
I hope you found my video informative. Please give it a like, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. You'll find the red button in the lower right-hand corner.